Hello students, today I'll discuss access control, or we can call as controlled access. What do you mean by access control? First of all, access control means what? As the name suggests, we are giving control on access, or we are putting some control on access. Till now we had two types are there of access control. First one is broadcast list and second one is point to point link. Now till now we are discussing about point to point link only. One source was there and one destination is there. Simply source and destination will transmit the data. But let's say I'm using the broadcast link, then this kind of access control mechanism should be there. So here broadcast link, one LAN connection is there. With that LAN connection, five devices are connected, A to E, right? So now at a time, if one station can transmit the data, if more than one station can transmit the data, then obviously it will create a collision. So for that, different mechanism is there that how we can control stations to transmit, right? So at a time means how we can synchronize between the station. Different access control method are there. First one is TDM. TDM means what? Time division multiplexing. Now here, let's say this is one LAN. With that LAN, 1, 2, 3, 4, four stations are connected. Here, simply what I'm doing, this is 0 to T, this is my time slot. Simply, I'm dividing my time in equal parts, and each part or each time slot, I'm dividing or I'm assigning to one station. Here, let's say this is first, in this first time slot, station one can transmit. Second time slot, I'm giving to station two. Third, station 3, station 4. Likewise, I am dividing my time slot in equal parts and I am assigning equal time to each and every station. Now, what is this T of T and T of P? As you all know, total time is T of T plus T of P. What is T of T? T of T means what? Let's say station 1 is transmitting. At that time, station 1 is putting that data on this LAN, right? That time we can call as T of T, means transmission time. And T of P means what? Station 1 and station 4. Let's say this station 1 is my source and station 4 is my destination. Now station 1 is transmitting some data to station 4. So this total time, whatever time taken by station 1 to 4 or taken by the message to transmit from station 1 to 4, that we can call as propagation time. So here, total time is T of T plus T of P. So T of T means what? Time taken to transmit the packet, or we can call it transmission time. And T of P means what? Time taken for the last bit to come out, right? Here, through on this channel, last bit to come out. That time we can call as propagation time. Now, if I want to calculate the efficiency of this TDM, time division multiplexing, then normally, efficiency means what? Useful time upon total time or cycle time. So now, T of T means what? Transmission time. That is, we can call as useful time. Whatever time we are utilizing, or our bandwidth or our network, that we can call as transmission time. And in denominator, total time or cycle time means what? T of T plus T of P, total time. Propagation time plus transmission time. Now, if I divide this equation with T of T, then what will happen? 1 upon 1 plus A means what? T of T divided by T of T will give me 1. Same here also, it will give me 1. And T of P means A. A means what? T of P by T of T. Now, in exam, many times they'll ask an equation on this TDM. So now, let's say here I'm taking one example. T of T is equal to 1 millisecond. Means transmission time is 1 millisecond. Propagation time is also 1 millisecond. And bandwidth is 4 Mbps. Now, if I want to calculate the efficiency, then first of all, I have to calculate this A, right? So A means what? T of T means 1 millisecond divided by 1 millisecond. Simply, it will give me 1 millisecond. Now, if I give this value to this equation, 1 upon 1 plus A means what? Here, I already calculated A is 1 in my case. So 1 upon 2, right? So it will give me 50% efficiency. Now, if I want to calculate effective bandwidth, then effective bandwidth is simply efficiency multiplied by bandwidth. So here efficiency is 1 by 2 multiplied by bandwidth is already given 4 Mbps. So I am multiplying with 4 Mbps, so it will give me 2 Mbps. So this 2 Mbps or effective bandwidth, we can call that. What is this effective bandwidth? Means effective time of our channel utilization or total time. This is the time where we are utilizing our channel fully, and remaining all time we are doing this propagation delay and all extra stuff. So this is the time where we are utilizing our channel. Now with this example, let's say n stations are given or n station are connected to TDM network. Each station require 2 Kbps bandwidth, and how many maximum number of station can connect to this channel. So I'm continuing with this example only. Here I calculated till effective bandwidth. Now n stations are connected to this TDM. Each station required 2 Kbps, and how many maximum number of station can connect to this channel, right? So here n means total number of station multiplied by 2 Kbps, means each station required 2 Kbps. So I am simply multiplying with number of station is equal to 2 Mbps. Here effective bandwidth, whatever I'm utilizing the channel that time, we can call as 2 Mbps only. So n is equal to 2 Kbps equal to 2 Mbps, right? This is effective bandwidth. Means out of this 4 Mbps, I'm simply utilizing the 2 Mbps only. Remaining all 2 Mbps I'm simply wasting. So if I simplify this equation, then n equal to 1000. So with this channel, 1000 station can connect at a time. But what is the biggest disadvantage of this TDM? Disadvantage is only one disadvantage. If station does not have any data to transmit, then slot is wasted, right? So as I discussed over here in this diagram, through this diagram you can understand. Here simply I'm assigning one slot to each and every station. Now let's say station 3 don't want to transmit anything, then simply this time is wasted, right? So third slot is simply we are wasting the slot. So for that we are coming through new technology or new terminology that we can call as polling. Polling means what? Here no reservation means I am not simply dividing my time slot and giving equal opportunity to each and every station. Simply what I'm doing over here, simply asking one by one. If any station want to transmit, it can transmit, or else I'll ask next station. Here let's say B don't want to transmit anything, then I'll simply skip the B and I'll go to the C, right? So simply I'm skipping the B over here. I can skip in this polling example. So this is 0 and here I can write T. Sorry, I forgot to write. So this is my time channel, right? Or timestamp. On that T of poll. Poll means what? Whenever I'm asking each and every station to transmit the data, that we can call as poll. So T of polling time means whenever I'm asking that time. Then next time is transmission time. Let's say first I'll ask station A if they want to transmit or not. So A means A, right? Now T of T means let's say A has said that yes, I want to transmit the data. Now transmission time and after that propagation time, two times A will utilize. After that A transmission is done, now I'll ask B. That time I can call as polling time. After that, let's say B also wants to transmit over here, then transmission time and propagation time. Now this is one cycle. Every time I am using this three time, right? First one is polling time, transmission time and propagation time. But this is not the fair sharing. Means it may be happen that only one station is transmitting again and again and again, and some station maybe not have time to transmit, right? So it is not a fair sharing. But efficiency is more because I'm not utilizing or I'm not wasting I'm not wasting a single time slot. So that's why efficiency is more. Now efficiency, if I want to calculate the efficiency, then efficiency is equal to useful time upon cycle time, right? So here T of T is my useful time, or the time where I am actually utilizing the channel divided by total time. So here one cycle time is t of polling plus t of transmission plus t of propagation, right? So t of t divided by t of polling plus t of transmission plus t of propagation, that will give me the efficiency. Now effective bandwidth means what? Efficiency multiplied by bandwidth. If I'll do, then it will give me effective bandwidth. But here also some time I'm wasting, that is polling time. Polling time is waste in this case, right? Because every time I have to ask the station, and that time I'm simply wasting. So we will come up with new technique CSMACD that I'll discuss in next lecture. Thank you.